Hi everyone, wanted to do a quick update on the handheld FeatherWing, and if you've been following like the progress on Twitter, then you might be fairly well updated, but I still wanted to do it just for people who don't follow there, but you should. So first, before I go into it, let me explain what's happening here. Currently I don't have a proper feather to use with this feather wing. I would like to have a feather with SAMD51 or something like that that allows you to very easily upload files to the feather using CircuitPython. I ordered one, so it's on the way, so this will go away. I just use a custom board I made with some SAMD51 and then a feather for the battery stuff. So that's what's happening here, but the point is you can see it is not connected to any PC, so everything is running on the SAM. It is running off the battery, and it's all good. But before we go into that, let's go quickly through what's on this, what's on the board. And again, if you watched KaiCat streams, you probably know this, but for people who haven't, let's quickly go through it. So top to bottom, you have a NeoPixel here. You can, you know, you can show RGB colors, so it's really good for status. Here, 2.6 inch 320 by 240 display with resistive touch, four regular buttons, and then a five-way joystick here, and the famous BlackBerry Q10 keyboard, which is, I guess, the main selling point of this whole thing. Then on the back, let's see, we have a micro SD card, this on-off switch, which not very impressive, but it's good to have. This is the resistive touch driver and also GPIO expander, so a few GPIOs here are connected to it. And then here we have a axle and magnetometer combo, which you don't really need it, but you can mount it, and that's kind of nice to have. And lastly, there's a SAMD20 here acting as a driver for the keyboard, so it converts the keyboard matrix into an I2C slave, so the feather just talks I2C, doesn't have to worry about all the matrix stuff. And that's pretty much it on the hardware. It's like, it's a surprisingly simple board. And so I've been doing bring up yesterday and today of this, and I'm happy to announce that everything, every single component is now tested and it works. So this board, there's a few cosmetic things, so I will probably do a revision too, but like, this is ready to test, to run test code and just, you know, go crazy. And again, on Twitter, I have posted photos and descriptions of pretty much me testing each component, except the keyboard, which I will show in this video. So we're good to go, and yeah, let's have a quick demo session. So I turn it on, it boots into CircuitPython. You can see the nice blinker here, and I can show the NeoPixel. I have it. I wrote a simple code for showing some colors, and I can go with the brightness to way, way too bright. But let's turn that off. Then on the keyboard, I can adjust the backlight. As you can see, it's off now, and then in four steps I can go to full brightness. And again, that is over I2C, so the SAMD chip controls the backlight also. You just send a value over I2C, which I think is quite nice. And then for the keyboard, you can see hello world. You can see that it works very nicely. There you go, if it focuses. You might notice it's a bit slow, but that's because the code still needs some optimizations, like it's running just busy loops and so on. But otherwise, this is, I think it's true. It's really, I'm surprised myself that everything works on the first revision. It almost never happens. But these, like, I have 10 boards. This is the first one I assembled yesterday. So I'm hoping to assemble a few more and get them into people's hands, people who can, you know, help with the development before like an actual release. I'm still thinking which channels I should use and how to get this into people's hands, and if it should be a kit or an assembled thing, or how to do this. But yeah, I'm really excited about getting this into people's hands, because I think there's a lot of potential here for everyone to just unleash their creativity. You just slap a feather on it. You have Python, you have a keyboard. You can go wild with this thing. So yeah, that's pretty much the update, I think. Right, I can show, you can see here, like the initial idea was to have female headers, as you can see on this board, and then the feather just snaps on top. The problem is it's really tall, so I've been experimenting a bit with male headers, because with a male header, as you can see here, the profile is really low, and you could even cut off these and have it even lower, so that's something to explore. And then for the battery, as planned, the battery that I was designing this for fits perfectly here. So hopefully this coming week I get the proper feather, I can move this code into that, and this will be a properly handheld device where you can just, you know, hold it like this and you're good to go. So I think that's pretty much it. See you around.